There have been both frightening and spectacular scenes on Sydney Harbour as a controlled burn went wrong, raging through bushland at North Head. The flames could be seen for kilometres across the city, a sobering reminder of the danger that may lay ahead this summer.
A haunting sight on our harbour's edge. 20-metre flames as spectacular as they were shocking. The sea breeze whipping smoke and embers into a fire tornado.
It's amazing watching the fire. It's so bizarre seeing the red flames in the middle of the city.
The nightmare at North Head could be seen from every direction. Across the water at Vaucluse, crowds gathered, unable to peel their eyes from the orange glare.
You can see quite a bit. You can see it sort of, you know, catching and
the flames. So big. They were really big.
Ash everywhere. Our car is covered.
This was the view from the 43rd floor of an apartment block in the city. From North Sydney, a tower of smoke seen filtering into the night sky. Closer to the drama, locals on the northern beaches had a front row seat. And for those fighting it, this is what they were up against. A controlled burn gone terribly wrong.
Last night we ended up with 30 fire trucks here, 100 firefighters. We also had 3 water bombing aircraft. There was approximately 65 hectares burnt. The park was closed. There was 200 evacuations.
Residents returning home today, grateful their bush sanctuary had been saved.
It's nice to come home to not a burnt house because obviously we've seen so much this year of people obviously not being that lucky, so yeah, feel pretty lucky.
I guess you never know with a fire, do you? Like, you just got to hope for the best and hope that the fireys are onto it.
Even though the flames had been contained, the fight wasn't over. Flare-ups and hotspots drenched from the air and ground.
Not only does this national park have spectacular walking tracks, it is rich in history, discovered by the Indigenous, a quarantine site for plague victims, and a war memorial. And while some of it has been damaged, thankfully, none of it has been lost.
A spring taste of the threat we could face in summer. Tiffany Genders, Nine News.